Hey guys, welcome back to FIFA 22 Arsenal Career Mode. Today we'll be looking at four games today: Newcastle United, Blackburn, Liverpool, and also Huddersfield away from home in the what's that called? EFL Cup or whatever you call that one, Carling Cup or Carabao Cup. And yeah, this is going to be a very tough month as well, which means there'll be a lot of games going to be played, especially the one against Liverpool. We still haven't, honestly guys, we still haven't really beaten Liverpool so far yet throughout this series, and of course same as Manchester United, but earlier on in the season we beat them, I believe 4-1 or 5-0, probably in between those scores. But of course this one's going to be a real test against Liverpool. Unfortunately this year for them, it is not going to be their year, not quite their year. They're currently, I think, within like what, fifth place or something like that, but right now first place, we are out for grabs, and we're still kind of clear and ahead of Man City. I believe they are in the second position right now. So again, even though we have a very successful campaign so far, we still can't really underestimate all the opponents we have. We have lost two games already, which is, I think, I found that very unfortunate, and at the same time very ridiculous as well, embarrassing perhaps. And now of course moving on to the first game of the episode, we are playing Newcastle at St. James's Park, and right here, ooh, Joe Linton have sent himself off, I believe, with his second yellow card, and Joe Willock on the other side, thank you, he might be a double agent for our team. That's why Joe Linton has, you know, decided to slid in and got himself another booking, which means he is gone, guys. So we are taking this advantage. In the first half we were quite struggling, and then until that record happens, Thomas Partey just literally score. He doesn't score a lot of goals for us, but in the midfield he is quite solid. You know, he's that type of a build, 6'2", 6'1 guy who can actually very good with the ball and very good protecting with the ball as well. And Odegaard is looking for the third goal for today's game, trying to kill this game as soon as possible. In the 84th minute, here comes Fraser passing the middle to Murphy, but good save by Ramsdale at his chest height. And in the end, we beat Newcastle United 2-1. And yeah, it's a very good game in general, but of course that red card definitely helps us in terms of winning the game. And then in the next game, we are playing against Blackburn away from home. And then this is the big news, Champions League round of 16 draw, and we have drawn with Ajax. And this is, I don't want to jinx it, but this is quite, I think it is a quite easy draw, not gonna lie, no offense to Ajax, but that's how I felt, and I feel like we might have a chance to go for a quarterfinals, but of course we will have to see, because any team who plays in the Champions League, especially the teams who qualify for round of 16, they have to be pretty good in some level. So of course we're not going to look down on them. Instead we are going to play our best football right in front of him. And here comes Alexander Isak, second game of today, is playing against Blackburn at home, scoring the first goal already in 7 minutes. And as I said it before, Isak, phenomenal player so far. He is clear ahead of Dominic Calvert-Lewin. And 11 minutes in, we got the ball back. Here comes a counterattack orchestrated by Odegaard. And here comes Alexander Isak, passes the middle to Martinelli, and he finished that one off. 2-0 and two goals in 12 minutes. And surely, we pretty know this game. It's pretty much ours. We dominated throughout the first 10 minutes and scoring or taking every opportunity that we took. And here comes in the 30th minute, here comes Martinelli to Rabiot, got himself in the score sheet. Unfortunately for Rabiot, so far this season he has been be on a bench for quite some times, or on and off again, because honestly he just doesn't really score a lot of goals, particularly in playing that box-to-box midfield position. He has quite a lot of attacking or offensive responsibility and also defensive responsibility, but to be honest, for me, I don't think he has done pretty well throughout the whole season. But compared to last year, even though I changed the formation a little bit late throughout the mid-January with the arrival of Rabiot, and he has been scoring a lot of goals, but this season he hasn't been performing as well as I thought he would be. But you know what, it's good for him to actually get a score or get a goal back. and Martinelli right there scoring his second goal of today's game, extend to 5-0 within the first half. And of course, this is something that I really do like to see. It's just like literally showing no mercy. Whatever chances we have to take it with, like, you know, with dignity, with determination. And that's what we're getting. 5-0, even though we are 5-0 ahead of Blackburn, we still can't really like loosen up. But we continue to push, try and search for more goals. And here comes Martinelli looking for his hat trick, and he does with a great solo goal. Of course, a great pass from the back as well, and a very pinpoint pass as well. So Martinelli, a hat trick for him in the 66th minute already, which is good to see. And teams definitely are in a very good spirit as well. We're still looking to batter a team until like we reach double digit, but this is still part of my dream or an objective for this season. It's just completely dismembered the other team, to be honest. And Coutinho right here came on for Odegaard and just scores a pretty good goal right there. Literally a one-touch finish, a good pass from Martinelli. He's definitely played the game for me as well. Coutinho, unfortunately, this season has been shadowed by Odegaard. He is the backup of our cam, and also we have Houssam Aouar as well, just in case if any of them got injured. And right now we're moving on to Liverpool away from home at Anfield, but this time can we search for a sweet revenge against Liverpool? As I said, we haven't beat them for a while, and not in the last season, but this season, with based on our current form and also their position, or for Liverpool, this is going to be a very tough game for sure. And in the first half, I wasn't really paying attention, just like that. Bobby Firmino with the outside the foot long shot, and he takes a 1-0 lead against us. And this goal is definitely, there's nothing I can do. Ramsdale can't do anything about it. Even I watched the replay, there's no way Ramsdale was going to get the ball. Regardless, the ball was just like, you know what, just pinpoint to top left corner. And we're trying to find a goal right here. Saka got saved by Alisson, and the rebound, the shot has been blocked by Trent Alexander-Arnold. And here comes in 28th minute, looking for equalizer, and a great inside run by Smith Rowe. One touch finish, finesse that one into bottom right corner, and we have level up the score. 1-1, a very good finish, good composure as well. But of course, the vision by Odegaard has to be complimented in that case, because that was a pretty tough pass, to be honest. But I believe there is some flaw within the defense of Liverpool. And here comes an 39th minute, second goal for Bobby Firmino. A very good partnership between him and also Salah. That pass in the middle was tremendous, and they are taking a 2-1 lead. And of course, we are, you know what, still, we are trailed behind, but we still have the chance to actually keep on scoring. And here comes Odegaard right here, providing an assist, but also got himself a goal right there. A good play by Saka, you know what, just taking up all the spaces, keep running with the ball until one of our men is freed up. And that's what happened to Odegaard right there. And here comes the second half. Ronaldo Sanchez on the ball right here, inside pass to Alexander Isak, tried to chip over the goalkeeper, but good save by Alisson. But the rebound, it's completed by Odegaard, and he scored his second goal of today's game in the 63rd minute. Surely this is a big spirit for us, because we have been fighting quite a lot. Playing against Anfield is going to be difficult. And here comes in the 73rd minute, here comes Bukayo Saka dribbling by himself, and he's going to take a finesse shot, but good save by Alisson. And we still got a ball back in the box, and Van Dijk right there just trips Alexander Isak, and that is going to be a sure penalty. And yeah, Virgil van Dijk, a very clumsy mistake in the box right there. Look at the replay once again. And of course, Odegaard is on the first of the hat trick. I put him on, but turns out it was not a good penalty at all. Alisson has to be the player of the game for sure, 100%. 84th minute, here comes Bukayo Saka in the box again. We try to finesse that one in. Smith Rowe, but Alisson keep making a lot of saves. There's at least 10 saves in the game. And in the last minute, of course, just a very scrappy goal that we conceded. Ramsdale made a good initial save, but the rebound has been put at home by Sadio Mane. Tomiyasu tried to go for a sliding block, but he was just an inch late. And it turns out it was a 3-3 dramatic end in the battle against Liverpool. So moving on to pretty much the last game of the episode. But before that, we are going to extend the contract of Neto. I have no idea. I have extended him for like a... I didn't know I signed him a two-year contract in the last season. But of course, just extending a contract for him is very important because I think that he definitely deserved that contract extension. As I said before, if there is a... If I could vote in FIFA 22 for the player of the last or the group stage, he's definitely up there, Neto. And right now we're playing against Huddersfield Town and a Champions League side. Championship side, actually. Of course, it is going to be not a tough... I don't think it will be a tough battle coming on to today's game, but in the 18th minute, we literally conceded the first goal of the game. A very unfortunate one. Apparently, the other teams keep making some inside runs between our wing backs and also center back. That's how we keep conceding a lot of goals. And in 26th minute, we certainly have a lot of chances here. 27 minutes right here, Sammy Lekonga trying to take a shot, but the goalpost actually denies Sammy Lekonga's goal. Could have been a leveler right there. And here comes Calvert-Lewin. Good save by the goalkeeper. And we still can't really find that one goal. And honestly, it's very, very frustrating. And just like that, after not scoring the important opportunity here, we have a chance to, try to defend ourselves. And guess what happened? Ronald Araujo. Don't know what that guy was doing. He literally just tripped and allowed Huddersfield Town player to score that goal. And they're taking a 2-0 lead. And I was thinking, I was sitting on my chair and think, okay, this is getting embarrassing. Start to get a little bit embarrassing. And right here, I have no clue what is Saliba doing. I have no idea why he would think it's a good idea to try to kung fu kick the ball away. Instead, he could have used his head, but he couldn't. He didn't. And Huddersfield Town is 3-0 up against us. A very disappointing. And at that point, 60th minute, missing two important chances in the first half. And we keep making a lot of mistakes at the back. And I know this game, it has come to an end. 4-0 to Huddersfield, and this is very embarrassing. I know I said it in the Carabao Cup. Don't really care about the outcome because this game is more of a kind of like an exhibition from a rotational players who doesn't get a lot of game time. But there's no way I decided to put on such a poor team selection by me. And in the end, we are out of the competition. 4-0 to Huddersfield. Don't want to talk about that anymore. But that would be the end of the episode. We are currently at first. So far, we are 7 points ahead of Man City, which is pretty good, I would say. And United, City, Wolves, Liverpool. Liverpool is currently at 6. But right there, their draw against us must be massive to them and also to us as well, because Man City is coming back 7 points in, and we still have a chance to actually go for the title. But we will see. We're still kind of halfway through the season, but guys, stay tuned. Thank you guys for watching. Hope you guys enjoyed this video. Subscribe to my channel, and I'll see you guys in a bit.